Okay, see here, this equation we have. So efficiencies, now we have got that efficiency is 1 minus T2 by T mean, right? So if we have this equation, which is going to be higher? Okay, so if I am going to have higher T mean, if the T mean is going to have high, that means if mean temperature is going to be high, then what it would be, first suppose 1 minus T2 by T mean, okay, if this is higher value, okay, if this is higher value, how much it will become, first suppose you take some 2, for suppose what we have, efficiency is equal to 1 minus T2 by T mean, right? 1 minus. So for suppose if the T2 value is, let us tell that T2 value as 25 degrees centigrade and a T mean value, okay? So now what is T mean value? Let us say we are calling this T mean as high value. Let us that be 75. So 25 by 75, how much? 25 by 1 minus 1 by 3, what it will become? 3 minus 1 by 3, that means 2 by 3. How much is 2 by 3? How much it is? Let's calculate. The efficiency is going to be around 66.7. okay, for suppose if I am going to have T mean as 80, okay, this see T naught I have kept it as constant, and T mean is going to be 80. So 1 minus 25 by 80, how much it will become? 25 divided by 80 is 0.3125. 1 minus that answer, how much I am going now, if I have taken this T mean as 80, now I will get 68%. Which one is higher, either 66 or 68? 68. So that means if I have that proves that if T mean temperature is going to be high, then this efficiency is going to be high here. Okay, so in that way we can know that, or we can justify that if T mean is going to be high, then this efficiency is going to be high. At the same time, this also, if T2 is minimum, if T2, whatever the temperature here we have, that is going to be minimum, then also we will get a higher efficiency. Okay, by doing the same calculations you can know. Okay, in that way we can say that the if the mean temperature is going to be high, then the efficiency is going to be high. Okay, this is replica of nothing but this statements, whatever the statements I have said here, na, the same, it is going to, it is whatever I have told you now, that is the replica of these statements only. Okay, that means they are going to prove that these are true. Okay, so that's how we are going to increase the efficiency for Rankine cycle. Okay, now I already told these are the things which are going to improve the Rankine cycle efficiency. One is regenerative feed heating method and the other one is reheating. Simply we will call this method as regeneration method and this method as reheating method. Okay, let us discuss now or in the next class, depends on you. Tomorrow you will come to college, na? Definitely please bring steam tables. We will discuss several problems on that. Okay, and again in online class I will discuss this regeneration and reheating theory. Okay, so in tomorrow class I will discuss several problems on basic Rankine cycle. Okay, with that I will close here today, and if you have any doubts, please raise your doubts so that I can clarify your doubts. That's all for today. If you don't have doubts, I will end the session.